Dirk, today I got an email from Jane, who works in one of the casinos down in Tunica, Mississippi. And she wants to know, is employee theft really out of control?
Mike, it is out of control. That's what we have to all look at nowadays. In my experience as a surveillance person over the years, I have found internal theft in every single department in the hotel casino today. You know, when I look back over my career, you know, we started with, you know, people stealing buckets and running out the door, people putting tokens in their pockets. You know, it was, you know, the type of money we were looking at in those days were hundreds of dollars and maybe tens of thousands. Today, we're looking at hundreds of thousands. We're looking at millions as almost a routine occurrence. I mean, look at the last theft that we were talking about earlier, where, you know, we had one person in New Mexico that wrote false jackpots. He stole over $1,500,000. That's internal theft.
You know, let me also add to that, and Dirk's absolutely right. These people don't steal for, you know, hundreds of dollars anymore, even thousands. They go for the millions. It's like the Tran Group. You know, Casino Rama up in Canada, you know, over $2 million this one little team got from them. You know, we're reading about all these kickbacks, like the guy from Australia. How much did he get?
Well, he was able to get kickbacks of $5 million from the vendors, you know, just in a simple kickback scheme.
You know what? I might suggest this to you. Go to the internet and look under employee arrest and just take a look at the tons. I mean, and there are really a lot of them, depending on where you look, of all the scams that's going on in our casinos today because we don't have internal controls and we don't enforce procedures. And a lot of the procedures that we need aren't even on the books anymore.
Well, that's true. You know, and let's go back to the Tran organization a little bit because, you know, the dealers that were involved and were colluding with those cheaters, they were only paid $1,500, $2,000. It didn't take them much to go bad. And, you know, we all have people that are in, you know, economic times, and we're all having trouble, and it's not going to take much for those people to be pushed over to the dark side.
You know, here's another email from Jim. Apparently, I made a comment about the employee ID cards used to clock people in, and, you know, he wanted to know how that could be used as a scam. And in a lot of casinos, you know, this person makes that card up, then turns around, you know, he'll go to Human Resources and say, I lost my card. They make him a new one. I hand it off to Dirk. Now on days when I'm not coming in on time, Dirk clocks me in. But payroll, I mean, that department, the number of scams, unbelievable.
Ghost employees comes right to mind. It's very easy to set up within the payroll office, and you know, pretty soon you're paying you know, somebody that doesn't even exist whatsoever. You know, and a lot of companies don't even look for ghost employees, and that's been a scam for 100 years. You know, to have ghost employees.
Most of the time, though, it's usually committed by the person that actually has control, isn't it?
Absolutely.
So
absolutely.
It's like if I was in charge of payroll, all I'd have to do is make up a ghost employee,
sure,
and I get almost double my income just like that.
Absolutely. It's, you know, in most of the scams, you know, in internal theft, what we find is usually the person that has control. It could be the executive, it could be the supervisor or the manager that allows these things to occur, either by ignorance, by not looking through the controls, or by being part of the scam themselves.
You know, probably maybe 10 minutes before we went on doing this, we got a phone call. And the gentleman said, Mike, we understand you're doing an internal theft conference in Mississippi. We want to know who to send. I mean, which department should I send? And this program is designed for all departments, not just one department. Every department has paperwork. All it takes is one signature on that paperwork being forged. That's going to cost your company millions of dollars in the long run. What department would you say should go, Dirk?
Well, I agree. I think everyone should go. I mean, when I deal with these investigations and we get into internal theft, you know, really what it comes down to, if that supervisor in that department was trained to spot those types of things, they wouldn't continue for more than 2 or 3 days. They certainly wouldn't get up to the year and a half, 2 years that most scams actually go on for before they're detected.
Yeah, that was the statistic. They say that on average, it takes a minimum of 2 years to catch any employee that's pulling a scam. Another headline that I got out of the internet today was about a famous or a big name casino where their security guards are selling drugs.
Well, you know,
marijuana.
We all trust our security people, and we all trust our surveillance people, and really we have to. But on the other hand, those people, both security and surveillance, you know, they're human too. You know, they're subject to the same temptations, the same problems with money that we all are. You know, so it pays. We have to look at everyone. You know, we just can't leave one department alone. In fact, I know one of the other headlines was one about a surveillance person who went bad and actually held up, you know, the surveillance people so they couldn't report things and they couldn't turn their cameras. So, you know, everybody has to be looked at. Everybody has to be part of this.
They're really, that's what we're trying to explain. Every department is affected, and it's not until every director of every single department comes together and says, "Hey, look, we've got to put stops to these leaks that are draining our casino profits." Here's another case, Dirk. Casino employee accused of hacking system.
Well, Mike, you know, nowadays we do almost all of our work, if not all of it, on the computers. And unfortunately, we're not trained to use them to spot what's going on. But you know who's using them is the employees. The employees have learned to steal more faster by using the computers. And Players Club is a perfect example. You know, they're using those things to move the money around quicker than we can spot it. And, you know, we don't have the tools yet. Well, actually, let me step back. We do have the tools. We just haven't learned how to use them yet.
I mean, it's a question of pushing a button on a keyboard or pulling a trigger of a gun, isn't it?
Absolutely.
And you get more by pushing a button on a keyboard.
Absolutely. Well, think about a Tito ticket. How much money can you put on a Tito ticket? It used to be a bucket. Now it's a piece of paper, and you can put $1 million on there and walk outside the casino.
I think in all honesty, you need to understand that this is something that is very serious. It's spreading like wildfire. I mean, look at our economy. Look at the people that are losing their homes. One more thing, too, I want to add to, Dirk, before we sign off on this particular issue. We are now going to open this up to you. And if you would like to be like Jane and Jim here and email us questions, we would be happy to answer them for you as we do our weekly presentation to you. So, Dirk, what do you got to say?
Anything? Well, I would add that casinos need to know that they already have the tools to attack and reduce internal theft and fraud. It's just that most of us don't know how to use them. And that's what we're going to teach in our presentation. We're going to show you how to use what you already have. And I think that you'll find that you can reduce internal theft and fraud in your organization.
The upcoming seminar that we have in Mississippi, keep in mind that we're going to be sharing thousands of things with you, but we will be going over 125 specific different ways in which employees will steal from your property.